The modes of a major scale could be memorized, just like you do the timetables. The story goes that the Greek philosopher and mathematician Pythagoras, around the year 550 BC, was largely responsible for defining the notes A, B, C, D, E, F, and G, which became the full range of notes used in the ancient Greek musical system. They form the seven white notes we use on our piano today. From these seven notes, the Greeks gradually developed the seven modes. Each mode consisted of the same seven notes, but had its own unique tonic. The modes were named after the Greek region, or the people, from which it was derived, or from where it was particularly popular. In the key of C, the modes are Ionian, starting on the first degree, in this case C major, Dorian, starting on the second degree, D minor, Phrygian, starting on the third degree, E minor, Lydian, starting on the fourth degree, F major, Mixolydian, starting on the fifth degree, G dominant, Aeolian, starting on the sixth degree, A minor, Locrian, starting on the seventh degree, B half diminished, and back to Ionian, the first degree, C major. The modes are easier to see on the piano in the key of C. The first mode is Ionian, starting on the root, on C. The second mode is Dorian, starting on the second, on D. The third mode is Phrygian, starting on the third, on E. The fourth mode is Lydian, starting on the fourth, on F. The fifth mode is Mixolydian, starting on the fifth, on G. The sixth mode is Aeolian, starting on the sixth, on A. The seventh mode is Locrian, starting on the seventh, on B. Back to Ionian, starting on the root of C. The modes work like this regardless of the key they're in. For instance, if we were in F, the first mode would be Ionian, starting on the root, on F. The second mode would be Dorian, starting on the second, on G. The third mode would be Phrygian, starting on the third, on A. And so on throughout the modes. The modes work this way, regardless of key. The names of the modes are Ionian, Dorian, Phrygian, Lydian, Mixolydian, Aeolian, Locrian, and back to the Ionian. They remain the same, no matter what key you're in. I like to think of this in a chordal structure. One major, two minor, three minor, four major, five dominant, six minor, seven half diminished, and back to one major. I like to think of this as chordal structures. The first would be C major in the key of C, the one major. Then you would have D minor, two minor, E minor, the three minor, F major, the four major, G7 or G dominant, the 5 dominant. A minor, the 6 minor. B half diminished, 7 half diminished. Back to C major. This also doesn't matter what key you're in. For instance, if you were in F major, you would have the 1 major, the 2 minor, G minor, the 3 minor, A minor, the 4 major, B flat major, the 5 dominant, C dominant, the 6 minor, D minor, the 7 half diminished, E half diminished, back to the 1 major. This is not dependent on keys. There you have it, folks, the 7 modes and their corresponding chordal structures. If you have any questions or comments, don't hesitate to ask in the comments section below. Also, please feel free to subscribe to my channel for updates on my newest jazz video lessons.